Hi everybody, Nick Lahiri, Essel Environmental. Today we're here for a site visit for a phase one environmental site assessment. And one of the most common questions that we get is, what exactly is a phase one environmental site assessment and why do you need one? So this one is actually a vacant piece of land, and these are some of the easier types of phase ones that we do. But generally, a phase one is a desktop review of available documentation that relates to the history of the property. So on this property, the earliest available documentation is 1905. And this being 2017, we're going back almost 112 years to find the history of the site. And what we'll eventually do is go through the site and look for any potential evidence of underground storage tanks, unknown liquids, barrels of liquid, or anything from an environmental and a hazardous material standpoint that may be of concern. But 80% of the work that relates to a phase one is actually done in the office at our desk. And what that means is that we order historical reports, aerial photographs, topographic maps, sandborne maps, to really get a history of this site so that we can ensure that there weren't any type of commercial high-risk uses like a dry cleaner or a gas station from 40, 70, 80 years ago. And because these properties are older and they have a lot of history, we want to make sure on your behalf as our client that we are managing your environmental risk, and the phase one is really the first step. Now, we don't expect a lot to come out of this because this has been a residential lot for a long time, but let's say this was a gas station and there is evidence of tanks or there is evidence of a dry cleaner being present. Now, what we would normally do is call that a recognized environmental condition and recommend a further investigation, which is a phase two investigation, which now takes actual samples from the soil, the groundwater, to look for any potential contamination that may be present.
And if you want to flip around, show them that screen.
Yeah.
So right now you see two supposedly utilities or unknown objects from the line that we just...
That's running. It's running.
So let's test it out over there.
Yeah. I'll...
And my sample is, it's from 7 to 8 feet, so I label it. S-7, the top depth is the sample depth, -B1.
No air bubbles at all, because the contaminant.